Anointed One. This biblical title was bestowed upon him not in the very same fashion that all of us have been anointed, and on many different occasions throughout our lives, by having oil smeared upon us. Rather, he is in fact, by God's own design, the Anointed One himself. The very fulfillment of Isaiah's ancient prophecy. Christus means the Anointed One. And all of us who bear the everyday variation of his name, Christian, are identified with the anointing that he is and that he promises for the entire world. Christ was anointed by the Holy Spirit, and not with the oils that we will soon bless once again this year. His anointing designated him Messiah, another meaning of the word anointing. Our own personal anointings at baptism, confirmation, and when we are sick are always done with one of those soon to be blessed oils. And ultimately, those anointings are intended to configure us all to Christ, the Anointed One. This Anointed One commissions us this evening to continue his redemptive work in our world. We are to become his ministers of compassion and mercy, designated to freeing those who are imprisoned, feeding the hungry, quenching the dryness of the thirsty, comforting the lonely, and continuing his messianic ministry of salvation, especially for those who even today remain captive to poverty, who are all too often simply forgotten, neglected, and overlooked, and who are the very images of loneliness and victims to ignorance and fear. The Anointed One has commissioned some of us, unworthy as we all are, to share in his priestly office and to offer the sacrifice that sanctifies all of God's creation. We priests are anointed as other Christi, not because we are so much better than other men and women, or more deserving, or more worthy of this anointing. We are anointed simply because the Anointed One has chosen us, and in spite of ourselves, because his selection supplies the grace and the sanctifying reason for our office, and not anything within ourselves. Unfortunately, the behavior of some of us has caused the church and the entire world to question whether such a designation that we now enjoy within the family of faith is really the intent of Christ. The Anointed One certainly does not wish any of us to be treated as though we are privileged or exalted, treatment that he never sought. After all, the Anointed One chose to wash the feet of his disciples. We are to follow him in his humble service to our brothers and sisters. Each year we gather to bless and consecrate the oils to be smeared over those who are our sisters and brothers in faith. We also celebrate our selection by Christ, the Anointed One, to be his emissaries, his stand-ins, and his icons for the life of his church. We priests have to recall that our commission, our anointing, is ultimately to follow him in his sacrificial offering of self. To be a priest is always to be one like Christ, who empties himself out of love for others. We will renew our promises to follow the Anointed One in love and in service to his church. Later, after our Chrism Mass, we will honor a few of our number who have reached the special anniversary of fidelity, of devotion to the church, and of love for the Lord Jesus. They remind us of the countless hundreds of our number who have faithfully and generously followed and continue to follow the Anointed One. The oils that we bless and consecrate this evening derive their power from the Holy Spirit. It was that Spirit that first hovered over the abyss and brought forth abundant life in God's great moment of creation. It was that Spirit that overshadowed the youthful Mary, and within her womb began God's plan for our salvation. It was that same Spirit that descended upon the Christ as he emerged from the waters of the Jordan and confirmed him as God's own Son and Savior of the world. That same Spirit resides within the church and continually makes her fruitful and holy and the very wellspring of truth. We will summon that same Spirit upon those oils so that when they are applied to our people, they will be transformed into Christ's own people, anointed as was he, to follow the Father's commands. The Anointed One, at the moment of his death on the cross, breathe out that Spirit which animates his church and allows all of us to bear his name and continue his mission of mercy, reconciliation, and compassion freely extended to all who live within these 69 counties in North and Central Georgia, and indeed throughout the entire world. That is our common home and field of mission. And we are sent by none other than the Anointed One himself.